Afternoon, everyone. We will do broadcast first, and then we'll move to written. Before we start with Sky, Antonio wanted to say a few words.
Today we had a bad news, and our former youth coach team, Dermot Drammy, died. And I want to pass my condolences to his family and his friends.
Okay, let's start.
Afternoon, Antonio. Afternoon. Just on that note of Dermot, is someone who was Chelsea through and through and has spent so many years developing young players at this football club. How important are figures like him at a huge club like Chelsea that bring players through?
Yeah, I think it's a great importance to have this type of the person, this type of figure, to work for Chelsea in the academy, to develop the young players, and for sure this is a big loss, and this type of person are a great person, and they have a great value for the club, because it's not easy to work with the young player, and to work with the young players not only on the pitch, maybe especially off the pitch, and to teach them what is the life. Yeah, I think that this is for sure. We are sorry. We are sorry because this person was very important for this club.
Thank you. You go into this busy festive period having won 6 of your last 8 matches in all competitions with only 1 defeat. Do you feel Chelsea are in good shape as you look forward to this busy part of the season?
And the most important thing for us to have all players available, and this is very important because in this period very busy, it will be very important to make the rotation with the players. I think November, December, and also January will be very, very busy this period. We have just started this period, and for this reason it will be very important to try to rotate the players and to have a good answer of my players.
Is that why we've seen David Luiz step out of the first team, Cesc was on the bench at the weekend? Is that part of your plan for this busy period to rotate the squad and give everyone their opportunity?
No, I think to give the opportunity to my players, it will be very important, because in this way we keep the concentration very, very high, and the players that they need to rest, they can do this. Also because don't forget, if you play every game and you stop to train, no? And the probability to have an injury is very high, and I think that it will be very important to create a good balance between games and training.
Maurizio Pochettino after the weekend has ruled his Tottenham side out of the title race. There are 13 points behind Manchester City. Chelsea are 11 points behind. Do you feel you're still very much in the reckoning to win the Premier League this season?
First of all, I think that we are trying to do our best. And from the start of the season, we started this season with, with a lot of problems. I think that we have the points that we deserve. And for sure, there is Manchester City is doing something extraordinary. And to win every game and to draw only one game, it means that you are having a path. A great path, and But the most important thing for us to look at ourselves, to try to improve. I think that from the start of the season, we are improving a lot. We are becoming more solid. We are finding different solutions under tactical aspect. I think that we have to continue in this way, to continue to work, and then to try to do our best.
Up next, Swansea, a team that have struggled of late, 7 defeats in their last 9 games. But in the Premier League, are these types of games the ones that could surprise you? Is that where you need to be at your very best?
Yeah, but as you know very well, every game in this league is very tough. And we must pay great attention tomorrow against Swansea. And I remember last season we drew away, and then at home we won 3-1. We played very well, but at the end of the first half we were 1-1. We must pay great attention and to try to take 3 points. But for sure it won't be easy tomorrow, because every game in this league is very tough, and you have to face every game with great concentration, with great desire, with great will to fight.
As for Chelsea and the game, one player who stood out for Swansea this season is Tammy Abraham, who's obviously a Chelsea player on loan who won't be available for the game. Is he showing the type of form for Chelsea that perhaps you could utilise next season at Chelsea?
Yeah, I think that to talk about this topic now is very very soon, and for sure we are talking about young players with a really good prospect to become a Chelsea's player in the future. I think to go alone was the best decision for him and for the club, because in this way he's playing regularly, and this is the right way for him development.
It follows on the Ruben Loftus-Cheek as well at Crystal Palace, another Chelsea player getting good Premier League experience. Roy Hodgson intimated that potentially he could be recalled in January if he didn't play the right level of games. Is that something that might be on your radar?
Nah, but as I said before, I think this is not the right moment to speak about this during the press conference, and because I think it's important to always to have respect of the other team, and Ruben is another young player with a good prospect, with the right prospect to become a Chelsea's player and to play regularly. But I think that now is not the right moment to talk about this topic.
What's the Chelsea team news ahead of the game with Swansea?
Yeah. And the team news, I can tell you who are the players not available for tomorrow, and is Luiz for any problem, and Musonda, and then Bashuai and Kennedy. They are trying to find the best form to come back and to be fit 100% to come back.
We're speaking to Thibaut Courtois today. How important has he been for Chelsea this season, and how close is he to potentially agreeing a new contract to stay at Chelsea for a long time? How much of an important asset is he for your club?
Thibaut is one of the best players, the best goalkeepers in the world. Maybe he's the best, and for sure he can become the best goalkeeper in the world. He has great potentiality. Despite his age, he's very young. He shows great maturity in every game, and he's a really fantastic player in his role. And for this reason, I hope to find an agreement with the club. But I think this on this this topic. These are clubs' responsibilities.
Do you think that potentially could be imminent? Is that something that could get sorted sooner rather than later?
The contract.
Yeah.
I repeat, this is club responsibility, and but for sure, I hope in the future, Tiboyat and the club to find an agreement, because he's a really important player for us.
And finally, for me, no Italy in the World Cup draw. How disappointing is that for you?
Yeah, there is a great disappointment. After 58 years, Italy are not going to play the World Cup this summer. Yeah, as you know very well, football in Italy is very important. But now we have to face this new situation, a bad situation. But at the same time, we have to find the right strength, to find a new solution, and to come back.
And Tony, you mentioned earlier how important it was to have a fully fit squad going into such a busy spell. Are you worried that if you do get one or two injuries, your squad is not big enough and deep enough?
Yeah, but my hope, first of all, to have all my players available, and I have spoken before about our problems at the start of the season, and we started the season with a lot of problems because we started the season with a lot of injuries. And we started with Hazard, then with Pedro in our pre-season, and then with N'Golo and Moses. It's always important for every team to have all the players available. We know our situation, and we try to do our best in every moment. And then but I repeat, I'm very happy to work with my players, and to try to face every situation, easy situation or difficult situation.
How difficult has it been to keep Willian happy at Chelsea, because he hasn't started a great number of games this season, and most other Premier League clubs would love to have him in their starting 11? So has it been difficult to keep him as motivated as you would like?
But why are you asking me about William and not Hazard at the start of the season, and not Pedro the same? Yeah, the same situation, and every game I have to make the best decision. I repeat, my player must be happy to stay in Chelsea and to play for Chelsea, to play for our fans. They must be happy, and if they start the game, or if they stay on the bench, then come on. But I think that I have clever players to understand the situation, to accept the situation, because I repeat, and Hazard, at the start of the season, he accepted the situation to stay on the bench before to find the right form. And it's the same for Pedro, it's the same for Willy, it's the same for other players. When you are in a great team, you have to accept this, and at the same time, you must be happy to stay in a great team.
Playing Swansea means that Paul Clement will be coming back to Stamford Bridge. How impressed are you with him as a tactical coach? And is there a big difference between being a good coach and being a good manager?
This question is not about Swansea coach.
Yeah, Paul Clement. How impressed have you been with him as a tactical coach?
Yeah, I think he's a really good coach. And last season he did a really good job with Swansea. It's not simple. It's not simple to fight for relegation. But I have great respect for Paul for his job, and I repeat, he's doing a really good job, and I have great respect for him. I think that there is a big difference between manager and coach. You can be coach at the same time manager, but if you are only manager and you cannot be coach. Understand?
Right.
If you are a coach, you can be manager. If you are only manager, you can't be coach.
Okay.
Antonio, you didn't include Timber Bakayoko on the list of injured players, but he looked a little bit off the pace against Liverpool, and there have been suggestions that he's still feeling some pain in his knee. So what is his condition like, and what have you made of his performances?
Yeah, don't forget, Bakayoko is a player very young. He's only 22 years old. And yeah, for many reasons, and he played a lot of game, and I think he needs for sure he needs to improve under tactical aspect with us, and to go into our idea of football. But at the same time, I think that for a young player to play regularly with this regularity is not simple. It's not simple, but I think that he's playing well. It's normal. It's normal that you can alternate good performance with other performance less good. But I think he's a young player. He's working very well, and I'm very happy. I'm very happy for his commitment, for his behaviors. Yeah, but for sure, and he has a lot of space for improvement.
Antonio, for someone like Eden Hazard, who started the season injured, how do you tell him that he will have to miss out some of these games coming up in this busy period, that you need him for more important games, because he must want to play?
No, but I think that every game you have to try to make the best decision and to try to protect every player, and for sure, and to try to. I'd like to start every game with the best players, but at the same time I think that this is not possible. It's not possible because otherwise I don't protect them. I take the risk that I think is not right to take. Especially because the season has just started. And then we have a long season, and for this reason I have to try to protect every player. At the same time, it's not simple, it's not easy to leave great players to rest, no? But I have to do this because I want the best for the team. I want the best for the player. I try to protect my team. I try to protect the players.
For a player that gets kicked a lot, like Hazard does, do you have to protect him more?
Yeah, but as you know very well, the kick during the game is part of the game. Is a part of the play, no? And for sure, to try to stop him, and sometimes you have to take tough decision, no? tough decision of our opponent. But I think Eden is an important player. He's an important player, and he's used to face this type of situation. He's used to have patience to support this type of situation. Yeah, but I think that it's normal in the past or in the present. If you see, for Messi is the same, no? For Neymar is the same, and for Ronaldo, for these players that they are very good, they are very fast, they are technical players, and it's very difficult to stop them.
And finally for me, on Luis, the knee injury, is that a long-standing injury or is it a new injury?
I must be honest, and in this moment it's very difficult for me to answer this question, and will be the doctor to assess the situation, to assess very well the situation, and then to take the best decision, yeah, for the player.
How long is he likely to be out?
No, I don't know. I don't know.
Well, yeah, we'll wait for the doctor to assess. We can probably update you tomorrow. We need to wrap up. Nizar, do you want to finish up, please?
Hi, Antonio. Is Victor Moses ready to start tomorrow?
But Victor Moses is ready. He's in contention. He's in contention for tomorrow's game. But I repeat, at the same time, I need to make the best decision for the team, for every player. And yeah, for sure, Victor is backing from a bad injury, and he needs a bit of time to find the best physical condition. Yeah, but as you know very well, Victor is an important player for us.
Okay, thanks everyone. Cameras off, please.